ओके मिस्टर सत्या, हाउ डू आई डू क्वेश्चन नंबर 1।
सो फर्स्ट आई रोट सैंड इज टू ग्रेवल इज इक्वल टू 5:3।
ओके
देन आई डिड 750 डिवाइड
या
देन आई डिड 750 डिवाइड बाय 5 व्हिच इज इक्वल टू 150। देन आई डिड 150:3 इज इक्वल टू 450। सो माय आंसर इज 150 केजी ऑफ ग्रेवल इज मिक्स्ड।
You want the ratio to be sand to gravel, the ratio to be 5:3. So my sand is 750. So there are basically ways in which you can do this. You can use any of the method that you like. So this is the first method and this is the second method. You can use any of them. So here 5 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 150 would be 750. Therefore, 3 multiplied by 150 would be 450. So if I'm using 750 kg sand, then I need to use 450 kg gravel to maintain the proportion. Mr. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Another way is I write it like this, that sand is to gravel is to 5:3 and sand is 750 and therefore gravel would be X. And when I cross multiply, this is 5. So when I cross multiply, 5 into x would be equal to 750 into 3. And therefore x would be equal to 750 into 3 whole upon 5. And this would be 450 kg of gravel. This would be 450. This. Yeah.
So I did the calculation correct and I wrote the answer wrong. Like that.
But sir, then you need to revise. That is what I keep telling you. So once you have completed all the questions, I always tell you to revise. And that is what you need to check when you are revising. Mr. Sarthak, any doubt?
No, sir.
Are you able to do this question?
Yes, sir.
Did you get the right answer?
Yes, sir.
So, second part. Now I am using 750 kg of gravel. The ratio is the same. So if this is 750, then this would be X if I do it by method 1. And if I do it by method 2, then I need to find sand. I have been given gravel, which is 750. So this will be 3 multiplied by 3 to the 3, 5, the 0, 250. And therefore 5 multiplied by 250. Which is equal to 0251250 kg. And if I do by this method, then if I cross multiply, 3 into x would be 5 into 750, and x would be 5 into 750 whole upon 3. This would be 1250 kg. Mr. Sarthak, is your answer 1250 kg?
Yes, sir.
Sarthak?
No, sir. I did the first one also wrong, right? So this also I got wrong. Now I understand.
So what did you do, Mr. Sarthak?
Sir, I did the same thing. Like I did 750 divided by 3. And then I got 250.
we have done a lot of questions of ratio proportion. Now we shouldn't be making a mistake. Okay, Mr. Sarpa, how should I do this? Mr. Sarthak.
So, so I didn't understand this question.
Okay. Mr. Sathya.
Sir, yeah. I did like 150 into 4, then I did 500 into 4, and then 50 into 4, and then I got all the answers. So like the I need 600 grams of butter, 3000 grams of flour, 300 grams of sugar, and 400 currants.
Mr. Sarthak, let us try to understand this. See what they have told you, Mr. Sarthak, what they have told you that to form 18 cakes, you require this quantity. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, what they are asking is how much each ingredient would be needed to make 72 kgs. So, for 18 kgs, this is what you require. Now, you need to make 72 kgs. Now, the ratio would always remain the same. That is a given. So, 72 divided by 18 is 4. Sarthak, have you understood? So if this is getting multiplied by 4, each of this would be multiplied by 4. Is there any confusion?
No, sir.
Satya, am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So you will require 600 grams of butter, 2 kg of flour, 200 grams of sugar, and 400 grams of this. Sarthak, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Now let us try to understand the next part. Satya, were you able to do the next part, B part?
Yes, sir.
Okay, how did you do it?
So at first, when we make 4 cakes, we need 600 grams. So okay. Then I found the value of 1 cake.
Okay.
And then I multiplied it. So I got So my answer was 6 full cakes can be made.
Okay, let us try to understand how many whole cakes can be made with 1 kg of butter. Okay, let us try to understand this. So here I have 1000 grams of butter. Now, if I see 150, the ratio is 1000 divided by 150. 53 the 52 the 0. So this would be 36 the 18, 2 by 3 is the factor. Mr. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, this factor. This 20 by 3, 5 3 is a 15, 20 by 3 factor, or 6 2 by 3. Let me write this as 20 by 3. Now, this factor would be multiplied by the cakes also. Is there any doubt? Mr. Satya, any doubt?
No, sir.
Mr. Sarthak, any doubt?
No, sir.
So, I will be able to make 120 cakes if I use 1000 grams of butter. Is there any doubt? This is okay or any doubt?
No, sir.
See, what we need to understand is, one thing that we need to understand when we are doing questions like these is that, you know, in a way, this 150, 500, 50, 100, these are the ratios to make 18 cakes. So if I have to make 18 cakes, then this is a ratio that I have. Now, another way of looking at this is, if I want to make one cake, if I want to make only one cake, then if you are understanding, then I'll require 150 upon 18 of this, and 500 upon 18 of this, and 50 upon 18 of this, or 100 upon 18 of gram of this. Is there any doubt? Satya, is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Sardak, is there any doubt? So this is the, see, this gives you the recipe. This is the recipe of making 18 cakes. The ratio would always remain the same. So for example, let me take a rough example of, this is a rough example of making a tea. Yeah, you want to make one cup tea. So your mother will tell you to take, your mother will tell you to take half cup water, half 1/4 cup milk, let us say half spoon tea leaves, and half spoon sugar. Mr. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So this is your recipe. This recipe was given by your mother. Now one day your dad tells you to make 4 cups of tea, Mr. Sarthak. He tells you to make 4 cups of tea. So how many cups of water will you take, Mr. Sarthak?
4 cups, right?
Yeah, if you want to make 4 cups of tea, 4 cups of tea.
So, if 1 cup we
need
1 cup tea, we need half a cup water, then we'll multiply it by 4, so 4 into half.
Okay, can you calculate and let me know, both Satya and Sarthak, how much water, milk, tea leaves and sugar do I need? Can you please let me know?
Yes.
Yes, Mr. Satya. How much water do I require?
So, are you asking me?
Yeah, Satya, how much water do I require?
Yeah, so we need 4 cups of water.
Are you, why 4 cups of water, yeah? Mr. Satya, Mr. Sarthak.
So we need 2 cups of water, 1 cup of milk, and 2 cups, 2 teaspoons. Oh, sorry, I didn't do the sugar. We need 2 spoons of sugar.
Satya, are you understood?
Yes.
Are Dada, this 1 is getting multiplied by 4. Then everything will get multiplied by 4. This would get multiplied by 4. This by 4. This by 4. The ratio would remain the same. So this would be 2 cups of water, 1 cup of milk, 2 spoon tea leaves, and spoon sugar. Satya, is it correct?
Yes.
Sarthak, is it correct?
Yes.
So that is how it is done. So for example, if you want to make 8 cups, then the multiplying factor would be 8. So everything gets multiplied by 8. Are you doubt again?
Nice.
You would be seeing all these Master Chef and etc. Have you ever seen Mr. Satya? Master Chef?
Yeah.
Mr. Sarthak, have you ever seen?
No, sir.
So, for example, you want to make chicken biryani. So, they'll tell you how to make 1 kg of chicken biryani. So, they'll tell you you take this much rice, you take maybe just rough calculation 400 grams of chicken, then you take 2 spoons salt. Then you take masala, then you take pepper, maybe you will take 500 gram rice or maybe 100 gram curd, maybe. So basically what I'm trying to tell you is, so if I want to make 1 kg chicken biryani, so this is the ingredients that I have. Now, if I want to make 10 kg of chicken biryani, so everything will get multiplied by Mr. Sarthak. Mr. Satya?
10.
10. So everything gets multiplied by 10. It is very simple. Sarthak, any doubt?
No, sir.
So basically, if you see this Master Chef, Satya, kya chalta hai? Australia chalta hai, India chalta hai?
So that I don't know.
Jo bhi chalta, Master Chef Australia chalta hai, India chalta hai. Main kabhi dekha nahi hai, but you know, this is how they'll tell you the recipe. So they'll tell you the recipe of making, say, 1 kg of chicken biryani. So if this is the one recipe for making 1 kg chicken biryani, then you multiply the common factor by, say, for example, you want to make 20 kgs of chicken biryani. This recipe would remain the same. The ratio would remain the same. Sarthak, any doubt?
No, sir.
Basically, the recipe will tell you two things. One is it will tell you the ingredients. And the second important thing that it will tell you would be the ratio. Any doubt? So, when you are making a cake, they are telling you that these are the ingredients that you have. These are the ingredients. Okay, so you need 1, 2, 3, 4 ingredients. And then they are telling you the ratio. Basically, they are telling you the ratio. So, in all these questions that we are doing, you would be given a recipe. A recipe implies that they will tell you how to make a certain thing. And they will also mention the ratio. When you are looking at the ratio, the important thing is what is the common factor which is there. That is what you need to understand. Okay. Mr. Sarthak, what are you able to do? Question number 3?
Yes.
Okay, good to do.
Red upon white, so 1 is 1 upon 12 equals 1 upon 12. So white paint for 1.4 liters. Red.
Satya, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
What would be the final answer, Mr. Sarthak? Is it correct? Mr. Satya, is it correct? So, this is what is the answer for the A part. Then B part. Mr. Sarthak, how should I do? B part?
Sir, I didn't understand this part.
Father, did you understand?
No, sir.
See, the red paint is, if the red paint is 1 liter, the white paint would be 12 liters. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, 1 liter red paint and 12 liter white paint will make a mixture of 13 liter total. Is it correct? Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, see, what you can do is, say, I take the ratio of red is to total. Is it okay?
Yes.
Red is to total is 1 is to 30. Mr. Sarthak, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
And white is to total would be 12 is to 13. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
You understood what I've done? See, what I'm saying is that if the total formed is 15.5, the total formed is 15.5, let the red formed be X. Am I correct or not?
Yes.
Yes.
And similarly, if you know white is a total is 12 is to 13, then if 15.5 is a total, then the white form would be, let it be Y. Yeah. Have you guys understood what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Sarthak, is there any doubt?
So I'm still not able to understand.
Have you understood that the ratio of red to total would be 1 is to 13? Have you understood this?
Yes, sir.
Have you understood that the ratio of white to total would be 12 is to 13? Have you understood till here?
Yes, sir.
Now, what I'm telling you is that the total paint that you have got is 15.5 liters. So the denominator would be 15.5. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, here, the total would be 15.5. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, if the ratio of red to total is 1 is to 13, then I assume red to be X. So it would be X is to 15.5 and this would be Y is to 15.5. Mr. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So X would be 15.5 if I cross multiply. So this would be 13 into X is equal to 15.5. Therefore, X would be 15.5 upon 13. Similarly, when I cross multiply here, this would be 13y is equal to 12 into 15.5, and y would be 12 into 15.5 upon 13. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
And then you can use calculator or whatever. You can calculate that. You can calculate the final answer to the nearest 0.1 meter. Sarthak, any doubt? Sarthak, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Sarthak, were you able to do A part?
Sir, yes, sir.
Mr. Sarthak?
R is to Y is equal to 8 is to 5.
Okay.
Then I did. Then I wrote 200. And then I divided 200 by 8.
Okay.
So then I found how much do I have to multiply 5 with.
Correct. Correct.
Then I multiplied 5 with 25.
Correct.
Then I got 125 and yes, sir, then we found the answer.
Sarthak, were you able to do it?
Yes, sir, but I didn't understand this.
No. Is the A part correct? Is your A part correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now again the same thing. What we have discussed right now. So red is to yellow is 8 is to 5. So if you have 8 bulbs red, then you will have 5 bulbs yellow. Is it correct?
Yes.
The total would be 13. So, ratio of red to total would be 8 is to 13. And ratio of yellow to total would be 5 is to 13. Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, the total is 351. So let red be X and total is 351. Let the yellow be Y. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you let me know the value of X and Y? Mr. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
See, 8 upon 13 is equal to x into 351. So I do cross multiplication. 8 into 351 is equal to 13 into x. So x would be equal to 8 into 351 upon 13. Now these two divide each other by 27. So 8 into 27 is 216. Similarly, when I calculate this, I have to cross multiply. So 13 into y is equal to 5 into 351. And therefore y would be 5 into 351 upon 13, which again when I calculate this becomes 135. Satya, is it correct?
Yes.
And another way is that once you have calculated red, so for example, if I had calculated x to be 216. I can subtract 216 from 351, which was a total bulb, to calculate 135. Anyways, the answer is 135. Sapi, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Sapi, have you understood?
Yes,
sir. Yes, Mr. Sarthak. How did you do fifth part?
So, first I wrote orange is to mangoes equals 9 is to 2. So,
orange is to
So, orange is 189 and mangoes is 9.
Yeah.
189 upon 9 is 2x upon 2.
Yeah.
So, then when we divide 9 and 189,
yeah.
21 is 2x upon 2.
Yeah.
So, 21 into 2 equals x. So, 42. X equals 42.
Yeah. So, Satya, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
So, whatever way you are comfortable with, whatever way you are comfortable with. So, for example, I know that orange is to mangoes is 9 is to 2. So, 9 is to 2 and I have 189 liters of orange juice. So, I require mango juice. So, mango juice would be X. So, again, when I cross multiply, 9 into X would be 189 into 2 and X would be 189 into 2 by 9 and the answer would be 42. So, see, the point is you can use whatever method you are comfortable with, whatever you find comfortable. The fundamental thing to remember is this factor, once you have understood how to use this factor, then the things are very easy. Mr. Sarthak, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Mr. Sarthak, were you able to do B part?
Yes, sir.
Okay. How to do B part?
So, orange upon total equals 9 upon 11.
Shabash. Very nice. So,
equals to X upon 605.
Shabash.
And mango upon total is 2 upon 11. So, Y upon 605.
Shabash. Very nice. Satya, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Very nice. So again, if you have understood the crux of ratio, then the question becomes very easy. Otherwise, if you try to cram the method, then it becomes difficult. So for example, once you have understood, once you have understood that orange is to total is 9 is to 11. So this 9 is to 11. So if I have total 605, then orange would be, again I cross multiply. So 9 into 605 upon 11 is equal to X. This is the orange juice that I require. So 11 5 the, this would be 9 5 the 45 and 495 liters of orange juice. Now one shortcut is that this is the total juice that you have, 605. You have already found the orange juice, which is 495. So rather than calculating this, you can calculate this, not an issue. Or you can subtract total and orange juice, you will get the mango juice. The 110 you have got here would be the same if you multiply 2 into 605 whole upon 5 and 11 5 the, this again would be 110. So I think any doubt? Satya, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, Satya, Sarthak, what I'll suggest is, You do this as homework and submit before Thursday 10 a.m. Is it okay?
Which questions?
All these questions again. All these questions. Sarthak, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Because these are good questions. You should do them again and just submit them before Thursday 10 a.m. Remember this. Yeah?
Okay, sir.